You know, we pretty much all have an opinion about the perfect temperature for our thermostat. But now, official numbers from an EPA group called Energy Star, you know, like the folks that do all of the appliances, it has set off a heated debate, to be sure, because now it's recommending that you keep your thermostat at 82 degrees while you sleep. And they say that way you get the most out of your AC while reducing energy. And joining us now is Dr. Luis Ortiz. He's a sleep physician at Johns Hopkins All Children's. And we got to ask you about this because I've been hearing cold, dark room, or at least a cool, dark room forever is optimal for sleeping.
Yeah, that's actually right. So a lot of studies in the past have shown that the optimal temperature is going to be around 69 to 72 degrees Fahrenheit. Now, when you look at the more studies, if you look at the skin microclimate, which is basically the few inches of air around your body underneath your sheets, yeah, that does kind of hover around 80 to 85 degrees. But we actually need that cooler air to transfer that excess heat off to. And so, you know, when I first heard those recommendations, it did raise my eyebrows a little bit. That is a little bit on the warm side. And granted, you know, Energy Star is more towards conserving energy,
right,
and improving the environment. And so on a science point of view, that may make sense for energy conservation, but it may not make quite enough sense for human physiology.
Yeah, our bodies may not like it so much. By the way, the Energy Star, the other recommendations, just so you'll know, is 78 degrees at the coolest when you're home. That's probably another whole debate.
Yep.
85 degrees when you're away, and then, of course, the 82 degrees when you're sleeping. And don't our body temperatures, I mean, they change when we sleep,
yeah,
right?
So part of the natural process when we fall asleep is that we, as humans, as mammals, become a little bit cold-blooded. The processes in our bodies that maintain our core body temperature kind of relax a little bit and actually encourage release of body heat. So humans actually drop 1 to 2 points in body temperature when we fall asleep. And being able to do that is kind of a sign of having good sleep. And so on the flip side, though, if we make it easier to maintain our core temperature despite being a little bit cold-blooded, by increasing it by 1 degree, we sleep a little bit better at the same time.
Okay, because 82 degrees, I mean, especially if you haven't been doing that, I'm thinking that could be tough to acclimatize to, couldn't it?
It is, yes. And there have been studies that show that if it gets too hot, if it gets too humid, it can be really difficult to fall asleep and get good sleep. You get less sleep, you get less deep quality sleep. So there's always going to be a point where from the ideal of 68 to 72 degrees with 50% humidity to 95%, 95 degrees and 75% humidity, from everyone sleeping well to no one sleeping well, along the way, people are going to start dropping off. And I feel like at 82 degrees, keeping your, and then when you keep off your AC, that your humidity in the house is going to go up.
Right.
I think, at least for Florida, it's not quite right.
Okay. So the bottom line for you, ideal temperature is probably more like what?
So, like you said, everyone's different, and it's going to be a combination of warmth and humidity. And so what I would say, where you're at right now, you know, if you want to start conserving energy, maybe, you know, increase the temperature by a degree every few nights. See how you feel, see how you slept. If you didn't sleep very well, then go back to the lowest temperature where you slept well.
Then you know where your upper limit is. So, and by the way, I would have really flunked the energy savings, just telling you that. Thanks so much to Dr. Luis Ortiz from Johns Hopkins All Children's Hospital. We thank you for your point of view, and the debate will rage on. Linda, Paul, we know it will.
What, I mean, the question